From the studios of Tucson Business Radio X, recorded in the Stewart Title corporate offices on Broadway, you are now listening to The Mark Bishop Show. And now here's your host, Mark Bishop.
And welcome to another show. You know, 45% of Americans say that they've overspent when shopping for holiday gifts. This is in years past. Overspending is preventable, and by approaching the holidays with a plan, you can stay on budget and find ways to maximize your spending. Well, Jason Gaughan, he's the Senior Vice President, Credit Cards at the Bank of America. Welcome, Jason.
Hey, Mark. Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, most welcome. Look, being strategic about your holiday spending, it can help decrease financial stress, can't it? And it'll allow you to focus on what truly matters, like spending time with family and friends, in person or virtually. Would that be fair to say, Jason?
Absolutely. I think, the holidays can be fantastic, and at the same time, for many people out there, that they can be awfully stressful. So, in terms of how to, make it less stressful, I think it starts with, setting a budget for yourself, a detailed budget for yourself, and sticking to that budget.
Yeah, what I'd like to do is go through some tips in just a sec. Just share with us, please, mate, what are the biggest holiday spending mistakes that you see?
So I'll give you a couple. The first is being tempted by all the deals that are out there. So back to having a plan, it's really important to have a plan. And don't be tempted by all the deals that are out there. I know my Achilles heel whenever I'm doing holiday shopping, and I personally do a lot of it online, is I see all these great deals, and I end up buying stuff that I didn't plan on buying. And I end up buying stuff particularly for me that I had no plans on buying just because I think it was a great deal, and then I'm quote-unquote saving money. I'm really not saving money because I didn't plan on buying it.
Right. My mom used to say, in a case like that, Jason, your eyes are bigger than your belly. You can't help it. Let's get into the advice for tackling financial stress. Do you have any? Because, I mean, you've been there. What advice can you give for that?
Yeah, so you're right. I have been there. I think it starts with, don't overspend. Have a budget. Have a plan. Plan ahead. It also means don't wait until the last minute. 33% of Americans in a recent survey that we did said they wait till the last minute. I think, waiting to the last minute causes desperation, overspending, bad decisions. And this year, it's going to cause even more stress because you've heard about potential, supply chain challenges in terms of things being available, as well as potential delivery challenges because of how overwhelmed the postal system and UPS are going to be, for example.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I've given up on that. I've ordered a few things online, but now I do not do it, trying to date it to give it as a present to the day. I'm just lucky to get the darn thing. Listen, what financial tools or products, should I use this holiday season to help me track expenses and stay on budget?
Yeah, so I give your listeners a few pieces of advice. So, I talked about, spending and budgeting. Bank of America has some great tools that can be used for spending and budgeting. They're available on bankofamerica.com. We also have a financial literacy series that's available. It's called Better Money Habits. So it gives you spending tips, budgeting tips. And then lastly, I would tell your listeners to look more broadly than just the deal that the particular merchant may have. In many cases, your financial institution may have partnership with specific merchants where you can get a little bit more back. And then look at how you're making, what are you making your purchases with? So a great example is Bank of America has a cashback card that allows customers to choose the categories that they want to be rewarded. So, this holiday season, 65% of Americans say they're going to be doing all of their shopping online. Customers can go into that particular reward card and say, I want to be rewarded for 3% cash back on online shopping. And they can change their category for the holiday season, which really allows them to stretch their dollar a little bit further.
Well, you're saying, be strategic online. I mean, online shopping is convenient, But tempting, you know, holidays, deals can lead to overspending. And, you know, you've got to stay vigilant, I guess, and focused on only purchasing items on your shopping list that can help you avoid buying unplanned items like you talk about. What about tracking your spending, you know, and being flexible?
Yeah, I think there are a lot of different tools that are out there. You know, you can use traditional pencil and paper. You can use things like Excel, or you can use kind of the Bank of America spending and budgeting tool and the alert system that we put in place that allows you to get reminders on, you know, when you're going over your budget and things of that nature. So there's a lot of different tools out there. I would just encourage people to use them.
What about the Bank of America mobile app? Isn't that a great thing about the spending and budgeting that allows for account activity and monitor your short and long-term spending patterns? How does that work?
Yeah, absolutely. That's back to the spending and budgeting tool I just referred to. That is a key component of the Bank of America mobile app. The award-winning Bank of America mobile app, I must add. We have built a lot of tools and capabilities based on feedback from our customers to help them manage their financial lives better, whether that be through products, whether that be through tools, whether that be through different alerts that we have. All of that can be found on the Bank of America mobile app.
And there's a lot of good stuff on this website to read about, the bankofamerica.com /credit-cards. That's for more information, folks, on that, and there's a lot more to it. The safely bringing everyone into the shopping fun is an interesting one. I mean, 43% of Americans say their favorite part of the holidays is the quality time they spend. But, you know, with the pandemic, I mean, how about shopping virtually with others? It's a helping peace of mind and, you know, keep yourself accountable. That's a good idea that you give.
Yeah, Mark. You know, I know one of my personal traditions, I have two teenage kids, and, you know, we pick a day in the holiday season where we go out together as a family and shop for their mom. And we generally go out to lunch afterwards. And, you know, once I pry them off their devices and get them off their couch, we're, you know, we make a day out of it. But, you know, what we're going to do this year is we're going to do that shopping online. We're going to, you know, be in front of our computers. We're going to talk about, hey, what are some of the things that mom would like? And then we'll shop for her together. And, you know, I think one of the things that's, you know, unique about the times that we're in, I think it's allowed us to be more creative. And really, I encourage your listeners to just take the opportunity to create new traditions, be more creative on, you know, what you're doing this holiday season.
Yeah, I know, man. It's tough, isn't it? Everybody's sick of being more creative. But you got to be. You got to be. You know, this site, yeah. This site of yours with the Bank of America, www.bankofamerica.com/credit-cards. There's a lot on that. And I really like this cash rewards dig, mate. That's 3% cash back in a category of your choice. So if I want to go buy a dirty big 75-inch at Best Buy, as an example, TV, would I get 3% back on that?
Yeah. Yeah, if you know, choose online shopping, and you will get cash back in that particular category.
Wow, that's really nice. Is there anything else that you really want to be, that we haven't talked about, that you want to get across, Jason?
No, I think that, you know, in the order of importance, the things that I hit on is really have a budget, have a detailed budget, track, you know, your progress against that budget. Don't be tempted into buying things that you have no intention of buying. And then just have fun and be creative and make the most out of hopefully this once-in-a-lifetime holiday experience this year.
Well, very, very good, mate. Well, I hope you have the best you can with your family and your two little ones. Are they boys or girls?
One of each.
One of each. Oh, well, what, a year apart?
not a year apart.
Well, Jason leads a team, folks, of associates. They're committed to delivering a best-in-class product for their customers. And he began his career at the Bank of America way back in 1994. So he's been around a while. He's not just a talking point. He lives the thing. He has a wide range of management positions in product, credit risk management, marketing, credit operations, all sorts of things. So he knows what he's talking about. Take his advice. Have a very safe, Thanksgiving coming up, buddy, and leading into Christmas. And hopefully we'll talk in the new year.
Thanks, Mark. And happy holiday to your friends and family as well.
Jason Gaughan, ladies and gentlemen, Senior Vice President, Credit Cards at the Bank of America. And you heard that with the Mark Bishop Show right here on Tucson Business Radio X.